What's going on, guys? It's Patrick here, and welcome back to another Top 10. Ladies and gentlemen, we are getting deep into these, and today, guys, we are going to be covering the Top 10 worst bosses in Call of Duty Zombies of all time. So with the release of Black Ops 3 Zombies, there have been a ton of new bosses added into the mix. Now, just to clarify, when I say boss, essentially what that means in Zombies technically is any sort of special enemy that is not a zombie. It's especially easy in Black Ops 3 Zombies to think of bosses and then think of something like the Giant Keeper boss or the Spider on Zetsubou. But when we talk about bosses, we're talking about all types of bosses that are not zombies. Now guys, before we get into the video, I just want to quickly mention that there is 1 week left to make your order on the Z House shirt, and then after that, they will be completely gone. So if you want to buy one, top link down in the description. But the other thing I'm going to run for this video is if you, let's say you can't afford one, I'm going to do a giveaway. All you have to do is be subscribed to the channel and comment down below what your least favorite boss is in Call of Duty Zombies. One winner will be selected in contact, and you will get a free Z House shirt. Anyways though guys, let's get into it. So coming in at our number 10 spot, guys, this is going to be Avogadro, the lightning electricity boss from Transit. Now, honestly, I think the Avogadro boss is a good representation of everything that Transit is. A nice idea, a lot of potential, and something that just fell flat on its face. If I do explain why Avogadro is disappointing in one word, I would say he has the same amount of health as a denizen. So when a denizen is latched onto your head, it takes 5 normal knives to kill him, and that's the exact same amount of damage it takes to kill Avogadro. With Galvanuckles, denizens die in 2 hits, and you guessed it, so does Avogadro. What's even worse though, is the EMP grenade is a one-shot kill to this man. But when you kill him, he doesn't even die, he just always comes back for more. To me, the Avogadro boss was a very cool design and a good idea, but it just seems like it's lacking something. They could have made an epic boss fight against this guy. Like, imagine fighting him, and it's like in the setting of the Dreisendrak boss fight, just like things coming at you. It would be so cool, but he's just got no health, and I don't know. I want to like this guy, but he's just lacking so much, and for that reason, he comes in at number 10. Moving down to our number 9 spot, guys, we have Corrupted Keepers. Now, I'm not talking about the giant keeper that's a boss fight on Dreisendrak. That thing is cool, but normal Corrupted Keepers are just straight up lame. Okay, what is a Corrupted Keeper? You take one of the coolest entities in Black Ops 3 Zombies, the Keeper, and you make him red and a bad guy. I don't know, man. Like, on Revelations, when you actually get that Keeper and he's working for you, it is so cool. And the Corrupted Keeper is just, it's just stupid. Like, that's just a Keeper. Why is he working for the Shadow Man? Why isn't he working for me? I don't know. I don't like this guy. He dies. It just doesn't make sense. I like Keepers. I just don't like the Corrupted ones. Moving down to our number 8 spot, guys, we have the Thrasher from Zetsubou no Shima. When you kill a Margua head, you get 500 points, with up to 1500 points per total Margua killed. When you kill Brutus, you get 1000 points. When you kill a Thrasher, you get nothing. And okay, I guess you could say like, yeah, you don't get anything from killing Panzers either, but Panzers don't spawn in every single round. Thrashers take a ton of ammo to kill, can one-shot you if you don't have Jug, and give you absolutely nothing. Like, not even a drop? Nothing. Just straight nothing. I think the Thrasher fits in perfectly on Zetsubou, and I understand they were going for that feel of like, we just want to make the player have no ammo and no points, but really? You're going to give me nothing? If you're not spawning in that often, or if it's like a dedicated spawn, I can understand that. But you can get a lot of Thrashers around, and that is just a straight issue. Now, if I had my way with the Thrasher, we would have tossed that thing out of Zetsubou no Shima long ago and added in Shrek.
Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me.
Okay, let's just move on. Moving down to our number 7 spot, guys, we've got an old enemy of mine, the astronaut zombie from Moon. Last time I talked about this guy, I got just a little bit, okay, I got really, really triggered. fuck this guy. Fuck him. I absolutely hate this boss. He's like herpes. He just keeps coming back. You get rid of him, you can shoot him in the head a million times with a ray gun, and he's just gonna keep on coming back. He never leaves you. Yeah, you can kill him, but guess what? He's gonna be back again next round, ready to just fuck your day. Fuck this guy. Fuck him. I hate the astronaut. Back in the days of Black Ops 1, this guy literally ruined my entire experience on Moon. Now, the reason he's only at number 7 on this list is because I actually think he fits into Black Ops 3 Moon a lot better. We've got all these perkaholic scrubs, I mean, totally not me, playing, and then you're running around the corner and he's like, boom, I gotcha, you lost your jug. I like it. But for the average player, the astronaut zombie is just still a pile of dicks. Not quite a bag of dicks, but certainly a pile. Moving down to our number 6 spot, guys, we have the witches from Buried. A long time ago, I made a joke about these witches, basically equating the fact that they steal your money, and I said that they remind me of women. Dude, 2017, that joke would just simply not fly, which is why I do not endorse that anymore. But I still freaking hate these things. So on one side, the witches can be very beneficial. They give you free perks, but they also take all your money. Now, I'm not trying to make a correlation between getting something easy but also losing a lot of your money, but if you were a smart person, I'm sure you could come up with something funny. 2017, man, I'm not even gonna touch that joke. I'm sorry, let's just move on. Moving down to our number 5 spot, guys, we have the parasites from Revelations, but more specifically the ones on Shadows of Evil. I had a conversation with Jason Blundell about these things. We were sitting down, and you know what he told me? He said, parasites on Shadows of Evil are popcorn enemies. What that means is they are meant not to kill the enemy. They are not meant to harm the enemy in any way at all. They are simply meant to distract you and let either a Margwa or a zombie kill you. That is the most genius and evil thing I have ever heard in my life. He just straight up says, yeah, they're pointless enemies. They're just there to distract you. So pro tip, if you're ever playing one of those maps and you're worried about one of those guys, don't worry about those. They're only there to make you to make you lose your focus on the thing that's actually going to kill you. But that's the problem. It just makes for it being a stupid boss. It's actually a super smart design for an enemy where it just distracts you. But for that reason, I hate it because when he told me that, I realized, like, shoot, how many times have I gone down trying to kill a parasite and then I get slammed by a Margwa? More times than I care to admit. Number 4, Black Ops 3's Hellhounds. Listen, I feel bad for putting these on the list. Black Ops 1 dogs, I like them. Black Ops 2 dogs, I like them. World at War dogs, I like them. But Black Ops 3 dogs, I do not. The point of a Black Ops 3 dog is to be a super fast and lightweight enemy that can be killed very quickly as well. Similar to the idea of a popcorn enemy, but what a dog is there's a specific time I hate dogs. You're dip, duck, dodging, diving through hordes of zombies and you get hit 4 times, okay? You're very red, you're about to die, but you're the clutch plays and you make it through that golden. You're fine, you're alive, and then a dog comes shooting through like a friggin' rocket strapped to the moon, out of nowheres, and boom, that last hit that you needed to go down, he takes it, he gets the win over you, and you just downed. How many times has that happened to you? Again, more times than I care to admit. So the dog, again, it's kind of the same sort of idea of a parasite. It's not meant to be the enemy that takes you down, like a Panzer or a Margwa, but just that thing that, you know, if you don't take care of it, it's going to get you. Number 3, Nova Crawlers. So this is going to be an unpopular opinion, but personally, I think the number one thing wrong with Keener der Toten is Nova Crawlers. The issue with these guys is more so, again, a Black Ops 1 thing than a Black Ops 3, but still certainly applies to Black Ops 3. I'm playing zombies, I'm doing my thing, and that's the point. I'm playing zombies. And I've just always had a huge issue with the Nova Crawlers. It's like you're shooting up here, you kill all the zombies, and then you've just got all of these stupid four-legged dudes running around. Another problem that I have with the Nova Crawlers is the fact that they've been used over and over again. You've got Jumping Jacks, which is literally just a more acrobatic Nova Crawler. You've got the teleporting ones on Moon, which is literally the exact same thing as the one on Kino, but they teleport. It was an idea that should have died with 5. Like, it fits on that map, you know? But after that, like, we should have just let that idea go to die. I literally just can't think of anything good to say about Nova Crawlers. Like, they don't make my zombies experience better. Very rarely do I get killed by a Nova Crawler. Very rarely does anything happen besides they become a minor inconvenience. And that's the problem. They add a cool effect to Kino, I will admit, with them crawling down the sides. But besides that, I just don't think they have that much value. I think they're kind of lame. And they come in at number 3. Number 2, Denizens. I mean, let's be honest, guys. If we're making a top 10 worst special zombies, bosses, list, whatever you want to go over, we got to talk about Denizens. Now, the Pat from 3 years ago would have gone on a rampage about these things. They are the worst thing to ever happen in zombies. They are God's gift to the stupid people of the world. All the savage quotes that I have said in the past. But I'm actually trying to make amends from things like saying paint thinner jokes and all that stuff. So what do I want to say about Denizens? If you get a Bowie knife and they're just in front of your face and you knife, it'll actually one-shot them. So that's nice. They make the Pack-a-Punch challenge on transit almost unbearable. But you know what? They sure do keep me entertained in the fog. And I mean, if they didn't exist, I'd be able to actually train in the fog too. And we wouldn't want that. Not to mention, they make the map much harder as they waste your ammo and give you no points whatsoever. And did I mention they're infinite? Politically correct Pat 2017, let's go. But coming in at our number one spot, guys, we have literally the stupidest boss in any Call of Duty Zombies map ever. And it is the Elementals from Shadows of Evil. Did you know that not only is there a special enemy that can be killed without attacking it, but you can actually end an entire round by doing nothing? These things are so stupid, you don't even have to fight them. They're supposed to kind of be like a dog where they're that fast enemy that rolls in and slams you, but the problem is they have their own dedicated round and you don't have to kill a single one of them. Like, how are we gonna call this a boss, a special enemy, whatever, when I don't even have to attack it? It literally just slams into me and dies. Like, if I was playing and I was doing a speedrun and I had to do, you know, had to do stuff quick, I could just go to the bathroom that round, come back, and I got a free max ammo. And furthermore, it's not even like they're a deadly enemy. I don't think I've ever died from one of these things, ever. But you know what? When you've got a name like Meatball, that's kind of expected. But anyways, guys, that is going to be the video for today. I hope you enjoyed this one. And again, guys, if you want to get in on the giveaway to win a Z House shirt, all you gotta do is comment down below what your least favorite boss is and subscribe to the channel. Other than that, though, guys, thank you very much for watching. I will see you later. Peace out, you frickin' nerds. Get down!